Hello and welcome to another episode of my Working with Apple series. My name is Carl Pullin and this week I'm going to run through some of the changes that have come to reminders in iOS 15 and how that can affect our overall productivity while using reminders. Now, what I'm going to show you is how it affects the time sector system itself. This is some brilliant updates. I'm sure you're going to get a lot of value from this video. Speaking of which, if you do get a lot of value, then please help me by clicking on that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, and you want to get all the latest tips, tricks, and news on using Apple's productivity apps, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, let me take you into my reminders now and let me show you how I am getting the most out of the new features in iOS 15. Okay, so here we are with my today view. Now, what you're going to notice are a number of things that were not available in the previous reminders. Number one of which is this area here called tagging. Now, for the purposes of this example, the tags that I've used are just personal and work. Now, that's just my minimalist, if you like, gene, is that I've learnt my lesson. When you have too many tags or contexts or labels, it becomes a complete mess. What I'm looking for is simplicity and ease of use. So here I've got my tags. You'll also notice that what I've done here is I'm using the priorities. You can see that by the exclamation mark here. Now, to add a priority, all I have to do is click in the task like I've done here next to exercise, go to the I button, click on that, and if we go down to the bottom, toward the bottom, you'll see that we've got priority. And you have a choice, none, low, medium, and high. Now, the way I'm using these are, high means tasks that I would like to do in the morning. Medium means tasks I would like to do in the afternoon. And low means tasks that I will do in the evening. None usually means that it's a low priority or doesn't actually have to be done today. It can be done any day. So I'm not using low. So for this particular one, I've gone on completely. It's a medium because I know I do my exercise in the afternoon. So there we go. That's done. Now, what you've noticed is I put that down as personal. I've got work, work, personal, work, work. So I've got the two tags into my today folder. But this is not where I'm actually working from on a day-to-day basis. I love workflows, and the smart folders allow me to create a workflow. So I'll just show you the smart folder I'm using right now. And if I long click on that, it's just going to give me show smart list information. So I'm just going to tap up on that. Down there, I've got today's focus because this is what I'm going to focus on. And you'll see here when I hit the smart list, this is tags. So anything that's tagged personal or work, most of my tasks will be. I've got a relative date range. Now, the reason being is that there isn't a date range which says today. So my relative date range, let's just go into here, is, let's have a look, in the next, so I've got it right here. So I can do in the next 2 days, in next week, next month, next year. So I can actually create a lot, but I'm just going to get in the next 1 day. That's my relative date range. And, oops, let me go back in there. And also, it has to be flagged, hence the reason why I'm going to be using flags. Now, I could use priority. And what I have done here is it's not off, it's any. Now, the reason I've chosen any is because if I turn it off, it actually means that anything that is either it has a priority or doesn't have a priority. This is the reason why I'm using priorities. It also helps me with sorting, and I'll show you that in a moment. So that's how I've got this today's focus filter set up. So what I can do now is I've just got two because there's two flagged. If I go back into today, which is up here, if I go to today, you'll notice that there are only these two that are flagged, and that's it. Now, going back to what I mentioned before a moment ago about sort, in iOS 15, actually this came out a little while ago, you can sort, and I sort by priority. That's why I'm using the priorities as morning, afternoon, and evening, because then it organizes my tasks for me in the order that I want to see them. So I can start at the top. Those are going to be my morning tasks. Then I can move down to the two exclamation marks, which are my afternoon tasks, and so on. That's done. Now, let me go into my inbox, and I do actually have one in my inbox. I have water plants. Now, my wife asked me to do this. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to type in tomorrow, and you'll see that it turns blue. And down at the bottom, if you look down here, it says suggested date tomorrow. So I'm just going to tap on that, and now that's been done tomorrow. Now, this is a request from my wife, so it's going to get flagged. Now, remember, in order for it to be to come up in my today's focus priority list, I need to give it a priority. Now, when am I going to do this? This is the question I will always ask myself. When am I going to do this? I know I'm going to need to do that in the morning. So I'm just going to do that in the morning. Job done. The plants will be watered. Done. Now, that's not going to show up in my today's focus. Actually, it does, because it's relative date range, remember, within the next 2 days or within the next day. And I'm recording this, as you can see, it says 9:41. It isn't. It's actually 9 p.m. So this is actually, because it's tomorrow morning, it's going to be within the next 24 hours. That's how Reminders is seeing it. So that's actually quite good. You'll also see that because I've got the sort activated, sort by priority, that's come up at the top. That's great because I've already done my exercise and this is a job that I want to do later this evening, hence the reason why it's only got one flag. So that's okay. I can see that. Now, going down here, I've got my routines. And now in the routines, I've set these up also as daily. You can see these are all recurring tasks, and it says monthly, daily. And again, they've all got the label here. So I can just click on personal. These are all the personal things, and I can click on work. And these are I've got nothing with two tags. Let's just go back to work, and that will give me all my work tasks. So that's cool. I can just go in there. But the idea here is, and I'm going to show you this with a filter. What I would like to do is I'd like to create a new list. I'm going to add a list. I'm going to make it into a smart list. And I'm going to use the tag work. I'm going to put the date. Now, if you click on today, it's going to say any specified range date or date range. I'm just going to go in there, and you can see that I can just go, if I do this, it's just going to give me today. And once that's gone, it's gone. So I have to go into date range. I'm going to discard that change. Make this into a smart list. We're going to click on work, and I'm going to go into date range. So what we'll do is we'll click on there, relative range, I should say, and within the next 1 day. Now, I could do within the next 12 hours, but I'm going to go within the next day. Again, that's fine by me. And that's part done. I want this to be priorityed. So anything, so that means it must have a priority because I don't want to see the things in my focused list for work. And that's it, done. So I'm going to go today's, I like to put these in capitals. So today's work, and I'm just going to go done. Now that's going to come down at the bottom. So I'm just going to drag this up to the top because I want to see that there. So I'm going to go there. And today's work. So now I've got two things that are related to work. Review TR's advertising, and what are the categories of improvements for CPR. Both CPI. For both of them here are related to today. So they've come up. They've got the priority as evening tasks, and that's those set up. Now what I can do is I can do another list, and I can do the same thing, but I'm going to call this today's home. Just for argument, I'm going to give that a different color. And I'm just going to go into here. And this time I'm going to tag personal. Again, I'm going to go into the date here, turn that on, relative date. Again, within the next day, within the next 24 hours. And then I'm going to go down here. And again, it must have a priority. And that's done. And there you go. That's my task for today. So again, that's come down at the bottom. So I'm just going to drag this up to underneath there. And so now I can just go into here and I can say, right, I've got my exercise to do and I've got my studying NLP. Now, the reason why you may want to do it this way is when you're at work, you do work. When you're at home, you do home stuff. You don't want the two to be confused. So today's work, when I'm at work, this is where I'm going to be focused. here I'm going to be into my home wife. So it's kind of like you switch over at the end of the day. Now, the beauty of reminders is what I've done here on my iPad is going to be crossed over onto my iPhone, and it will also be on my Mac. So these are going to come through. The only problem you're going to have right now as of today, the 1st of October, because the new macOS hasn't come out yet, it's not going to show up on your Mac yet. But once the new OS comes out, you will find that that will come out. So there's just a basic overview of what you can do and what's new in Reminders and how you may want to get things out of it. There is more to come. I want to show you how you can get email into your reminders by dragging and dropping, and I want to show you how you can attach a note to your reminders as well. But those are for other videos which will come out in the next few weeks. I just wanted to give you a setup, a way of creating a workflow, which is what we're doing here. So we can start off with today's focus. This has everything that is a priority and is flagged. These are the things that I must do today, because these are the things that I've decided are important. This prevents overwhelm, because although this list is only got six things, let's say most of us would end up with lists like this, really long lists of stuff to do. You want to be able to filter those out and make your life a little bit easier. So using these smart folders, you can really, or smart lists as Apple call them, you can really drill down so that you're only seeing the absolutely critical, must-do, objective tasks for today. Hopefully you found this useful. Thank you very much for watching, and it just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Well, thank you very much for watching this video. Now, if you want to take your Apple productivity systems to the next level, and you want to bring in your calendar, your reminders, your iCloud, and your Apple Notes all together into one beautiful productivity system, then please take a look at my Create Your Own Apple Productivity System course. It's completely updated for macOS Big Sur and iOS 14, and it's readily available now. All you need to do is pop over to my Learning Center, get yourself enrolled, and within about 90 minutes to 2 hours, you're gonna have yourself the know-how to build your very own Apple productivity system. I hope you join me in this course. This course now includes how to set up the Apple system using the time sector system, so you get a modern day time management system fit for the world that we live in today and the world that we're probably about to move into next year in 2021, 2022. Okay, thanks very much for watching this video, and I really do hope you join me in this course.